Yes, my talk will be about this new tool set that we are developing at Sci5. And most of you know Sci5, I guess. We do chips, we do RISC-V cores, we do integration of other cores. And one of the problems we have is the SoC integration. So every time we get several IP from different vendors, we can call it hardware components. We have to instantiate, configure these IPs, and we have to generate some of them because they are written in some weird languages like Chisel. And then we have to connect them together. Connecting IPs together require understanding of interface or integration intent of this IP. And sometimes it's just memory addressed buses like Amber. Sometimes it's clock reset power, a lot of plumbing, and plus DFT, DFX test, and a lot of infrastructure. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to understand how to improve the cycle of taking IP from somebody and putting them put it on the shelf that we can use it quickly. And it comes to idea why people do an IP blocks or components at all. Yeah, and the reason, the main reason is that we want to share development cost. If you develop one IP for one use, it will never be high quality, it will be high risk IP, and it takes so much time that you kill your time to market. And you're not going to succeed, right? So no matter what IP is closed or open source, it required to be stable, has multiple uses, and that's what reuse is about. And also, typically, it's, if it's not come with good documentation, nobody going to use it. And if it's not configurable, it's probably need redesign. So all these aspects are kind of important for reusability of IP if you're gonna share it or sell it. So what we came out with is to look and create new format. Format that will describe metadata about IP. It's okay to get very locked and try to dig into it or read documentation about it and trying to understand what this IP is about. It's better that to make this information available to computer to read. So it's metadata exchange format. And these days, it's common to have JSON file. It used to be XML, but these days it's mostly JSON. And we created this format. We called it Duh, which in most of Slavic languages means spirit. It was kind of patent original IP exact, which was called Spirit. Its idea is that you have body of a design and you have a spirit of a design. A spirit kind of describes what this body is doing, even though it's not design itself. So the project is open source now under Apache license, and it also comes with JSON schema describing these documents, and it comes with a collection of tools. So we have few documentation, so we call Duh documents. Each JSON file has special format and may be one of the type of the documents. And typical documents, design documents, would be component, which describe a particular IP block. It may be bus interface definition, like ACSI, APB, Wishbone, or Tilink. And that may be design, which is composition of components and maybe other designs. So it can be very compositional if you want. And there is configuration. When you have component, it's still configurable. So you can apply parameters. But when you want specific configuration, you have to fix parameters. So a repo for the Duh schema itself is also open source. So if you have written some JSON and say, oh, it looks like a Duh document, you can validate it. So bus definitions It's very common concept in SoC design. Because when you have block you want to reuse, you better use standard bus. It may be AMBA bus, it may be OCP, it can be any bus, but better to be standard bus. And to call it standard, you have to have some kind of description of this, what standard means. And this bus definition is basically, again, JSON file which describes what this bus definition is limited to. We have collection of typical bus interfaces in this repo, Duhbus, and it includes typical suspects like ACC4, APB. We have single port, dual port memories, and it's basically describe all this master-slave requirements, attributes of a bus definition. And it's typically referenced in the component documents by saying, okay, this bus is actually of this type. It can be used for validation and also it's supposed to be shared across multiple IPs. So this way you connect them together. So Duh component is basically the one JSON file that describes IP, describe IP integration intent. How you want to connect this IP? What's interface of it? At on a high level, there are multiple things you can describe. But on a high level, what you want to know is, okay, is it parameterizable IP? If it's so, what kind of parameters does it take? What is the constraints of these parameters? What is the schema of these parameters? What are the limitations of these parameters? And when you parameterize it, what would be the port like pin list of it? Which pins are actually buses and how they map to bus definitions that you have. Plus attributes and properties, that's another aspect. So if you have an ACC bus, you would want to know a little bit more about this bus. How many outstanding transactions does it keep on how many, you know, can it reorder transactions and so on. It's also important to know a little bit what is behind the bus, what's the memory map, does it have multiple addressable blocks, does it have registers, field, and so on. It's super useful for documentation. So if you have this document, you can automatically get a pretty good reference manual automatically. So actually, if you open this JSON file in the web browser, you will get HTML or PDF document out of it quickly. So this is the most complex document usually. Have to be designed specifically for IP. So we have a collection of tools to deal with this format. Even though it's open source, you can add new tools or contribute to any of these tools. We have about like 7 tools open source already, which help you facilitate designers to create, author, and manage these documents, as well as import all relevant information. So for example, for pin list, you would import it from Verilog, systemrdl, ipexact, whatever you have. Then once you get port list, typically designer will look at it and say, oh, this group of pins is actually looks like bus. So instead of people deciding, we created this inference tool. It's like kind of AI machine which knows about all the buses and look at the pins and names and say, oh yeah, that's looks like this bus with this probability. And they give you choices. And so you can pick one of the probable choices and if they match. We also allow validation of the documents because we have schemas, we have bus definitions, so we can run quickly and check that your document is actually, you know, makes sense. We have some expert tools and some formats you can use for expert is, again, if you want Verilog black box or model or ipexact or systemc. Again, we use it internally a lot because we integrate this foreign objects of Verilog with our nice Scala chisel diplomacy framework. So we will want to get this black box or wrapper quickly and parameterize it later. So this is kind of expert. So for import, we develop a set of parsers, one of those system Verilog parsers that was in a previous system Verilog test suite. We have a system RDL and a fertile parser. So that allow you to take any of those formats and kind of import all information you want. And we can also do it from IPExact. For inference, as I said, we have this tool which knows about some set of bus interfaces, and then it says, look at the port names and try to make sense which ports may be grouped into bus interfaces. It's not for sure if you have random names, as there is no chance it will figure out. But if it has, there is some sense in naming, some convention in naming, it will do the good job finding out, usually. But again, it gives you choices, so if you can abandon completely this step and do it manually, that's your choice. But even you have, you know, 8 Axie interfaces and doing it manually, it's a lot of work. So once you get this document, you have to write it yourself. So whole purpose of writing it in JSON 5 is human writable format. So you can put comments there, you don't need like double quotes everywhere. It's nice format. You're supposed to maintain it. But you know, every time you have question about does it comply with the schema or not, you can validate. So you can check, you know, the format, the schema, the, you know, content and completeness and consistency of this file. Again, we have tool for that. So for export, as I said, we have most of our systems assembled using Scala Chisel Diplomacy framework. Most of this code is in Rocket Chip, so you can imagine that we use it internally a lot, and we derive a lot of projects from it. It helps. It helps me because I'm not a natively a Scala programmer, and you know, when I generate most of it and just customize it when I need, it helps me a lot because, you know, I'm not fluent in this language. It also helps to other people to learn our framework because they can go quickly from RTL into Chisel Scala world, and then they get an idea, they can improve it. Okay, so so whole format, whole idea of open sourcing this format was to share it with you, and you know, find other projects that could use this format, because we believe that it's universally useful, you know, to share information about IP. Even if you're not ready to share very lock of IP with somebody, you can share this meta information about IP. So let's say you want to sell it, but your consumer don't know, you know, can you integrate it or not. You can discuss forever in the meetings, in the documentation, in the PDF, in whatever, in mail, you know, what kind of interface you have, or, you know, what, and there will be still a lot of misunderstanding between, till the moment you get Verilog, you press a button, it's, oh, it doesn't understand my, you know, my clocking scheme. And instead of it, you can share this metadata, and the tool that consume it should be able to extract a lot of integration intent from it. That's a point. And when you have collection of IPs, you want to ask all these questions about, you know, do I have IP of specific properties? Can I integrate these IPs together? That would be a very useful database query search format for IP databases of some sort. So again, this is open source right now, and you know, everybody welcome to contribute, and I hope it will be useful for more than us. That's how projects get mature, and that's how projects get basically grown up, because if only a few people using them, it's never get well documented and well designed. And yeah, it was mentioned yesterday. Starting next week, there will be Hacktoberfest. I'm gonna mark some tickets and some ideas with the stickers, and you're welcome to participate. That's probably it. Questions?
Hey, thanks for the presentation. Maybe I'm gonna start with one question, one comment. The question is about you had bus models or bus descriptions for AMBA and stuff. Do you also have one for Tilelink? That would be obvious choice for Sci-Fi, I guess.
We don't, because we don't have any hardware IP right now which has Tilelink on it, except internal, but we can put one, yeah.
Okay, so that's the first thing. And I guess the second thing is we have LibreCourse, and that's what I'm working on a lot. And probably it would be interesting to have kind of metadata that is available in those files kind of displayed somehow, and that kind of integrates nicely and then makes it easy to discover and search. Maybe we should talk more and see if something can be done there.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we have been talking about this before, and I think it's a very good thing, as it hopefully can go where IPExact didn't really succeed. So I was wondering, how have you handled the trade-off between complexity and configurability when it comes to interfaces? Like, how do you, have you ended up with some parameterizable interface thing?
Yeah, in general, parameterization is a very complex topic. Most of IPs we have seen have some kind of configuration tool. It's very difficult to dump 100 parameters on the user and say, okay, fill this very large parameters and you know what you're doing. Because they're very interdependent and they're very, very constrained. The fact that you can change some parameters in a defiance in Verilog doesn't mean that it will work. So most of companies provide some tool, and they're very bad at writing configuration tools. Some of them using Tickle, some Java, and some don't know how to write software at all, but they're trying to do it. So what we provide is a way to constrain these parameters, so we can automatically create a tool out of this file. So there would be some form which asks questions and all constraints there. I know that question of cross constraints is very difficult question, because we have some basic rules how to cross constrain parameters, but it's definitely area where we can improve. Currently, you can parameterize the widths of a port a certain kind depending on the parameters, but just put in a formula. If you have very, very complex cross constraints, we have to talk about how we gonna, you know, maybe we should put prolog in the file. But it's interesting topic. So the format is JSON 5, so it's not a language at all. So it's data format. Our formulas currently idea is prolog, because it's just constraints. So you can kind of infer what you like from the rules. I don't want to have a formulas in any specific language, because formulas work only one direction. So you can apply parameters and get the answer. You cannot get original parameters from the answer, which is not it's unidirectional. But yeah, that's one of the hot topics to discuss.
One quick question.
What do you see as the advantage of putting this information in a separate schemaed JSON as compared to embedding it in the HDL?
Right, so most of putting in HDL. Okay, so this format is kind of separated from design itself. So imagine you get this design IP block from some vendor. They're already done with VHDL or Verilog, right? So they're already done with design. So, but haven't described anything except in documentation. Right. So it's kind of impossible to ask them to put what you want in the Verilog design because they're done. You're buying it, right? Or you're taking it from open course and designer already gone fishing, right? So you really have no, in many cases, you have no capacity or possibility to go back into design and add something into design. So you have to create it like some metadata.
I think if it's okay to follow up, I think that's a great story for the sort of retrofit cases. Do you think there's a separate answer for new designs?
I wish because if you look at typical design and new design and any HDL and Verilog, in Verilog you cannot really express constraints on the parameters, for example, or cross constraints between parameters. You just say, oh, I have parameter A, and default value is 1,000, right? I wish they would have very good robust system to describe parameters, right? Or also, you have this inputs and outputs, but there's no robust system say, oh, this group of inputs or outputs is actually axi, right? All this is not in the language, and most of languages lack in them. Even, even modern, you know, Chisel and Clash probably have some information about it, but it's not, you know, not flexible enough. And if you design it in one language and it's niche language, nobody understands this language, JSON, kind of easy to traverse. You have Python, Ruby, whatever JavaScript you want. It's just read the file, understand it, and do it. If you have Flow, which include verification, RTL, documentation, so on, have so many tools to look for this information. So it's not easy to ask every tool to look at source code, or in Verilog, sometimes it's just impossible.
Can we take it offline?
How do you read this JSON 5 file in a Verilog or HDL?
You don't. Why do you need to read it in HDL? So this is information about the design. So design shouldn't know about this information. So the whole point, so you already, you're doing design in design language, but you have information about the design. You could probably, okay. So yeah, I have to understand scenario more.
So let's take it offline. Let's thank the speaker again.